Well, you know, when you design a car, you put in a whole series of gauges to tell you what's going on inside the engine, because you don't want the thing to start smoking or burning or grinding or making all kinds of sounds because you didn't know that there was something going on. You want a pre-warning of that. Well, our skin is our own set of gauges. And if you know how to read it, it shows a tremendous amount about what's going on inside the body. Unfortunately, one of the ways that dermatology and medicine has progressed is to find out ways to get rid of the problems, or basically cover over some of those various symptoms. So it's almost like, you know, you keep having that oil light come on, well, you just get out the black electrical tape and put it over the oil light, you know? And then you don't have to look at the light, there's nothing going on. And sometimes, of course, treating an acute condition with corticosteroids and such is a good way to calm it down if it's a self-limited condition. But if it's chronic and you keep putting tape over that, you may not only lose the effect of the medication you're using, but you may also be hiding something really important that's going on inside. And so my practice has evolved over the years to find out ways to read those gauges and find other ways to treat them. Now, what's going on in a lot of these cases is there's inflammation that's inappropriate going on in the skin. And where's that inflammation coming from? Well, the immune system is attacking something in the skin very specifically. And why is it attacking that? Well, when I was in my training, you know, if you had a food that was causing something or thought to cause something, then that food had to cause the same disease over and over again. Otherwise, double-blind studies wouldn't show it to be true. But fortunately, I had a lot of education that helped me understand more. One was I was trained as a dermatologist. I was involved with holistic and integrative medicine since 1981. I got to be with Jeff well before functional medicine had a name, when we'd just be a bunch of us in a room. And then a group of holistic docs, including people like Leo Galland, met for 17 years, and I was part of that group. So I kind of got in on the inside, and I started bringing this stuff over to dermatology. I also had a very other unusual and fortunate experience, which was that I was involved with cellular immunology since 1963. And my last laboratory was at the NIH, where we did work on immune recognition. And we found out something that validated all the stuff that I'd heard from people who were talking about nutrition, that there was a possibility that a very specific thing could cause a very specific reaction in a specific individual that would be different than other individuals. Basically, we found that there was a histocompatibility or a self-requirement besides the antigenic requirement for recognition in the cellular immune response. And applying that to my work, I then understood all of the things I'd been hearing about nutrition and healing. So I was able to combine all of this and begin to apply it to look in and be able to ask questions and get deeper and deeper. And the secret that I found, the most important secret that I want to share with you about what questions to ask an individual, is what was going on before your problem broke out. And also, what was going on before there were changes, improvements, or worsening? Because if you have a good understanding of functional medicine, of immunology, and of dermatology, you can begin to interpret those different changes according to what was used beforehand, and figure out, as kind of like the shadows on the wall of the cave, what was happening that was creating that problem. What were the actual stimulants for the reaction, and what were the other things going on in a functional medicine sense that contributed to that? For instance, was the gut, leaky gut, worse? Was there something that made the adrenals not work, the liver, all the different pieces? So I think what I'd like to just share with you is that this has tremendous implications for all the people who are putting Band-Aids on their skin and other inflammatory problems, and it also has tremendous implications for public health. Because if our environment and if our social and eating patterns as a nation is causing all kinds of disease, then we really have to go back in and rethink this and figure out how to make a healthier nation and a healthier world. Thank you.